hands, Lord our God. Strength and power.
Strength and power is our God. Self-existent, Lord our God.
Rejoice.
We rejoice in the strength of your power, Holy One. And forever we proclaim.
bless them.
Amen.
Because they have been, they bless us every Sunday. You need to bless them. Open your mouth and bless them. Yes, Lord. We ask that your blessings rain upon them. We ask that your blessings fall upon them. In all that they do, may they begin to see your hands. May they begin to see your blessings upon their lives. In the name of Jesus. Father, I pray in their greatest soul. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Jesus' name. Father, this one will always have reason to praise you.
Amen.
This one will always have reason to worship you.
Amen.
This one will always be there. They will always be strengthened. They will always be encouraged.
Amen.
No matter the situation, no matter what they pass through, Father, they will open their mouth to worship you.
Amen.
They will say, you are their God.
Yes.
They will say, take all the glory.
Yes.
Thank you, Father, because of what you are doing in their lives and what you continue to do. Blessed be to your holy name.
Amen.
In Jesus' most holy name we are praying.
Amen. In Jesus' name, fire.
Go back to your seats. God bless you. Let's put hands together for our Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To him be all the glory.
Amen.
I want to welcome all of you once again to this service. I bless God that you are here. I bless God for the good health. I bless God for his absolute peace upon our lives.
Amen.
And I'm happy that you are here. I want you to know that your being here is not by accident, but it has been decided in heaven that this day you are going to be here to worship God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today, I have a message that is not like every other day. And it is not like every other message. And by his grace, it is an instruction that the Holy Spirit gave me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it is not for everybody. Amen.
Amen.
I wish I were you, I would say, I believe it is for me.
I believe it is for me.
Since it's not for everybody,
for me.
I believe it's for me.
It's mine.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even some, the Holy Spirit said you need to balance your preaching so that the children of God will not lack in any way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, most times I'm not used to doing this, but when men of God come from outside, they come and do it. But sometimes we need this. It may be very difficult, but it is a way that God wants to lift somebody up. Amen.
Amen.
That's why I said earlier that it's not for everybody. Amen.
Amen.
The title of today's message is Principles for Increase.
Amen.
Principles for Increase. We're going to look at some of the principles of God that makes his children increase from whichever level they are. Because so many people, they are the same. I've known some people in this town, some are not here, some are outside. I've known them in this town for so many years. The same way I knew them, the same way they are. The same way they still are today. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Why? There's no increase, There's no upliftment, there's no change from their level. They still remain in one level. I pray that will not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By His grace, I've also known some of you. I know how you look when you came. I still have the picture of how you look like when I stood before you to preach. I still see the kind of face you had. But today when I look at you, I can see the increase.
Yeah.
I can see the level as well.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, that is what God likes. Praise the Lord. Even our brothers who just came recently, the way I saw them last time is not the way I'm seeing them today. I've already seen changes. I'm already seeing integration. I'm already seeing manifestation of the hands of God. Amen. So it is always good to move from one level to the other. Amen. What prompted this blessing? God gave me a scenario. I wasn't sleeping and I wasn't awake. I just found myself thinking of two scenarios. The first one was that a man was busy clearing a farm. The farm was so thick and tough. The grass and everything. The man had to do everything, sharpen the knife, clear everything, uprooted all the roots that would stop his crop from growing, did everything. But at the end of the day, after clearing and burning the bush, the land is prepared to be cultivated. He does not have a single seed to plant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if he needs a harvest, he must put a seed. But he has no seed. That one passed. Television noise woke me from my trance. All of a sudden again, I went into another one. I saw a fisherman going to the stream, prepared everything, and went. When he got there, he saw the fishes moving around. Very many. Very many. They were just moving around. But you know, for you to catch the fish, you need to put something to attract the fish to the hook. Something on the hook. You just throw the hook like that. The fish were just swimming around the hook. Nobody, no one could. He would just throw it up. No single thing. In the midst of plenty fishes, he could not catch one. Why? Because there were no baits that would attract the fish. Hallelujah. Before you go and fish, I think they used to get some, what do you call those things? Worms, it could be even smaller fishes, small things, to put on the hook so that the fish can be. He had nothing, he just went there with the hook and he caught nothing. When I woke up, my soul jumped on my body. I woke up and said, no, this thing means something. And the farmer spend all his energy. And there's no seed to plant for him to get harvest. Inside the rain, inside the sun, he's clearing and preparing the land. And now the other one, so many fishes, in the midst of so many, in the midst of plenty, he could not catch one. I said, oh, Holy Spirit, what are you trying to tell me? What is going on? Hallelujah. And he said, I don't want you to concentrate on those who don't know how to give. Forget them. But concentrate on the givers in your ministry. And call them, ask them to sow. Because for you to be able to be lifted, for you to move from where you are to the second level or to a higher level, you need something to push you up. We need a ladder to climb, isn't it? Hello? Have you ever seen somebody just jump up and just hang there? We need a ladder to climb. You must put a ladder and climb. And that ladder is what we are going to do today. Not everybody, I know, not everybody will come up. It is necessary. It is normal. God has already said it is so. But for those who will know it, I want you to know some of those things. Take note of these things so that the seed you sow today will work, will bring miracles to your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There are some of the principles you must follow for you to be able to eat the fruit of your seed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Before we go into the principles, I want you to know. Today we talk about Abraham. Abraham's blessings are mine. But Abraham's blessings did not just come like that. God always has conditions for you to be blessed. And if God wants to bless you, He gives you conditions. It is not free. Amen. Even salvation is not free. Is it not true?
Yes.
Salvation. For you to have salvation, you must what? Be born again. Isn't it? You must repent of your sins. So it's not free. You must sacrifice something to get salvation.
No.
The same with the blessings of God. For you to get the blessings of God, there are some things you need to do. And the first one is that you must be born again. Tell somebody by saying you must be born again. If you read John chapter 3, verse 3 to 8, the Bible told us that you need to be born again. And how can you be born again? By running away from those sins you used to commit. The things I used to do, I do them no more. Fornication I used to do, I do them no more. Stealing I used to do, I do them no more. There is a great change since I do them. That is me born again. Some of those things that I used to enjoy, they no longer look like enjoyment in my life. I enjoy doing this, I enjoy doing that, but now today I see them as sin. I don't indulge in it. That is being born again. Do you want to be blessed by God? Do you want to be under His blessings, under His umbrella? You must be born again. If you are not born of your father, how can you be answering his name? Hello? And David, why are you not answering Osiah?
Because Osiah is not my father.
Hallelujah. Evangelist, why are you not answering Osiah?
That is not my roots.
You don't have the same DNA. Praise the Lord. If you are not born again, how can you be calling Jesus? You are not of God. So you cannot call on Him. Your prayers is just, you are just doing what we call a jiggy jagger. You are just doing, let me just do it like others. You see, the Holy Spirit made me to understand that many people call on Jesus to me for nothing. He does not hear them because He said, I know my sheep, and my sheep what? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He's a shepherd. And as a shepherd, he knows his flocks. Just allow a herdsman, two or three herdsmen, to come together with their cattle, with their whatever. Let all the cattle mix together. You will see that at the time they move, each cattle will follow the owner. Hello? They will know which one belongs to them, and the cattle will also know their owner. They will just separate like that. It has happened before when I was little. We were going to the farm, and we saw a cattle rear coming from this side, another one coming from the other side. Ah. My grandmother hastened, we said, let's quickly move before these cattle put us in the middle. We walked very fast and left the main road. So while we were there, I was not watching. My grandmother was going in the front. I said, I want to see how this cattle will not bring some. Because you know that little boy's thinking. I was watching. They came, those ones, with their stick, they greeted themselves, they were just talking, the cattle's. Well, they will look at each other, they all mix up, because the road is not so wide. It's an old road, because already there was a new road constructed in our place. So they all mixed up and passed themselves. This one went, and this one went. I was moving, so how come? One thing that bothers me is that when they finished talking to themselves, this one was going, this one was going. When the cattle will be looking at themselves and touching themselves with their horn, the owner will just hit his stick on the ground. Papa, he will do so. You will see the cattle just change his head, face, go inside. The other one will move to the other side, say, wow. They know the voice. He knows his voice. As he hit that stick on the floor, the cattle turned. And when he made that, the cattle knew his voice and went. And that was how everybody went their way. Since that day, I knew what the Bible is talking about. When Jesus said, I know my sheep and my sheep. Praise the Lord. If you are not born again, you cannot be a part of his blessings. There are different kinds of blessings. But the blessings that are made for his children cannot be yours. And the Bible says, the blessings of God do a good unto man and add no sorrow. There could be other blessings, but not from God. And that one can bring a lot of sorrow. See somebody buying a car today, and tomorrow they said he had a very fatal accident. The car is beyond repair. Thank God for him, he's alive or he's dead. Hallelujah. The same person who was celebrating yesterday, praise the Lord. You see somebody, I've gotten a visa. Oh, God, don't bless me, I've gotten a visa. You will take the plane. He said that the plane crash. Or, as you get to the border of Europe, they said, no, we will not accept you, you go back. He has a general visa. But he's going back. The next is Botala Mohammed. Welcome to Botala Mohammed. Praise the Lord. I begin to ask questions. But you got a visa. The blessings of God will do you good. You will not add sorrow. Praise the Lord. There's a difference between God's blessings and the world's blessing. We go for God's blessing because God's blessing brings peace. God's blessing does not give you high-headed. It does not give you sleepless nights. Hallelujah. When you make your money, you enjoy your money. Some people, they make money today. they don't even know how to manage the money. They don't know where to keep the money. They don't even know what to do with the money. When they hear a police, they hear the police are going to collect this money. They are only here on it. Somebody enter their house. Before the person they walk out, they don't go and go there, but the body still there. Why? Because that body was a blessing to them, but a blessing from the world. Praise the Lord. We know the difference between God's blessing. If God blesses you, you see, let million people enter your house. You are very sure your body is safe. Even if you don't want to keep it there, you put it in the bank, nobody asks you questions. Because you can defend it any day, any time. But there are some people cannot defend it. So they are looking for where to keep it. They are looking for when they are asking them, you said what? They don't know what to say. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must be born again. If you are born again, then it will be better for you. Tell somebody it will be better for you. If you also read Matthew 6, chapter 33, it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. And what? His righteousness. Every other thing shall be added unto you. When you seek God first in all you do, He will add them another thing later. But seek Him first. Be on His payroll. Be on His register. When He calls, King Josiah, you should be able to answer. I should be able to answer, not you. You are not Prince Josiah. King Josiah, present, sir. Just like today, though. Many of us are not here. When you call their name down, they are not here. Absent. You know, in the class, those days, the primary school, there are people who know how to call absent. They know all the people who are not in the class before the teacher starts to back register. Praise the Lord, somebody. Was that also in your class? Before he said absent. Before they call the person, they said absent. Sister Precious, absent.
Absent.
Hallelujah. Amen, somebody. And when you come to look at what many of them not to come to present today, not to come to church, this is rubbish. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brother Morris, absent. Find out why he's absent. Amen. Praise the Lord. You see that somebody had maybe one get together or one party and they overuse themselves, that they will not be able to present themselves the next day. Hallelujah. Amen. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Righteousness. Yes. Every other thing shall be added. Every other thing shall be added. God, this is God's promise. When God promises, He never fails. Man can fail you. God can never fail you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The God I serve has never failed me. And He will never fail me.
Amen.
I also believe He will never fail you.
Amen.
Men will always fail Him, but He will never fail us. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we should give Him all He desires. Worship Him from the bottom of our heart. Serve Him with all that we have. And see what He will do. And see if He will not do whatever we ask from Him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Second principle is that you must believe and accept the fact that everything comes from Him. You want to increase. Sometimes you know the reason why it is difficult for some of us to bring out. Ah, if I don't bring this thing out, where I will get another one? You know, when we hear about some people giving their last, they say, ah, this one, yeah, that one, and him, will be an offering to him. Whether I will call it, how will I pay my house rent? How will I do this? How will I do that? Praise the Lord. You will not increase. You will be there. Praise the Lord. But if you believe that even He is the beginning, He is the origin of even what you have. You believe that you own nothing, He owns all. You'll be very free to give out. Praise the Lord. Believe will normally say one thing, and that word is a very big word. Eh? Very big word and very sensitive word. No mere mere. You see, as short as that word, it has a lot of meaning. Hello? The owner, for instance, I'm the owner of this glass. If, for instance, this glass can see where money is hidden. Hello? Or with this glass, if I'm passing through the bank, money will enter my pocket. I'm the owner. And I left this somewhere. Hello? Somebody that saw it. And he found out that anytime he passed through the bank, something entered his pocket. He's not the owner of the glass, so the owner of the glass who lost it, he never cried, he never shouted. But he will pick up. When he see the advantage, where they there? He can't leave her for one place. If they don't come back, they shout. He want to close the whole building. I left it here. I left it there. But now you get up. Don't be an idiot. Praise the Lord. God is the owner of all. Everything. Bible says the earth is the Lord. And the fullness thereof. The world and they that dwell therein. Hallelujah. He is the owner of everything. He says, silver and gold belongs to me. Hey, the problem with us is that we don't recognize the fact that He is the owner of everything. That money we are keeping in our pocket, that money we are saving to do this, to do that, that money we are using to build a house, to buy baby cars, He is the owner. Not until we recognize this fact, will not be able to give out and be praised. Praise the Lord. So you must recognize the fact that He owns everything. And everything comes from Him. Praise the Lord. Bible says, we love Him because He first loved us. We are not giving Him because He first gave us. Praise the Lord. That's about the book John chapter 15. The Gospel of John chapter 15. We are looking at verse 5. Gospel of John. John chapter 15. You are there, read for us, verse 5.
I am the vine. You are the branches.
I am the vine.
You are.
And Jesus said, I am the head. And you are the body. I am the vine. You are the branches.
He who abides in me and I in him bear much fruit.
Hallelujah. If you speak to this head, it's just like when your head is cut off. Tell me what happens to your body.
Dies.
Hello? Do we have witnesses yet? Can I have a witness? If my head is cut off, do you think this body can stand? Praise the Lord. God is the vine. We are the branches. If we are with Him, we walk with Him. We believe that He owns us. He is the owner of everything. That is where this will work for us. But when we think we are on our own, it will be very difficult. Many of us struggle because we don't recognize the facts that God is everything. Without Him, we are nothing. With Him, we can do all. Because He is what? The head. He's the vine. We are the branches. Thank you, Sita, my brother. Amen.
Amen.
He is the vine. We are His branches. No branch can bear fruit without the vine. Hello? There is no branch that can bear fruit without the vine. That is why it is very important for us to know that everything belongs to Him. So whatever we are giving Him His property. Don't see it as your own. If you see it as your own, you will not be able to give and you will not be able to increase. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The third principle is that you must be a blessing. When God blesses you, you must also bless others. As your blessings increase, let your giving also increase. Like many of us, and you give your offering maybe 10 euros or 5 euros. Now you are working, you are earning about 1,000 or 800. You are still giving 10 euro or 5 euro as offering. You remain the same. People will not see the difference between when you were walking and when you were not walking. Amen.
Amen.
When God blessed Abraham, He said, you must be a blessing. He didn't tell Abraham, I'll bless you, remain there. No. He said, I'll make you a father of nations. Nations shall come out of you. Today, look at the world. The world is spreading and increasing. Why? Because Abraham knew how to give. First, God tested him with his son. The only son. I'm not talking about one out of 12 children now. Today, even today, many of us with so many children say, bring one, say, in a lie. We say, that's a lying spirit that impugns you. But only son, the covenant child, many of us would have argued with God, though, because anytime I think about this, I say, Abraham was really a man of God. Many of us would have argued with him. God, you said you will bless me through this child. How come you will not tell me to offer this child? It's not to you. We will argue. But this man was so obedient. He was so obedient. Even when his son was asking, what are you sacrificing? Well, we have everything. But where is the Lord that will be sacrificed? He said God will provide. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And God actually provided. You see? The power of our hope. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, Abraham was obedient and he gave. He gave all. Let me just say that. For someone to offer his only son He gave all. So he had for at the end of 99. That was the kind of age some of us would call 40 something today. Now I'm 40 something. And now I want more. They say don't pass menopause. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Then they will now ask you to come and offer that child. You say, Lai, I rebuke you. Amen. For Abraham gave all. And God blessed him. And when God blessed him, he also blessed others as God commanded him. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you are blessed, learn to bless others. When you see people who are in need, learn to give to them. People cannot be crying and suffering in your presence. No food to eat. Nothing to drink. Nothing to eat. And you have enough in your home. You will not invite them to your home to come and eat. You have so many clothes you have not worn for the past 3-4 years in your home. This thing I'm saying is not just for you, it's even for me too. There are some clothes I've not worn for 3 years. I still see them for my wardrobe. What is it to do there? Whereas there are people who need this clothes, who appreciate it. Praise the Lord. We must learn how to give. The more you are blessed, the more you should bless others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't think about your stomach alone. See, when you think about your stomach, that's why you see many people, then they pick for every other for better, but then they pick for other places. Because they think about their stomach alone. Amen. You will see the leg, you go back. Like dido. Leg. Waist not there again because the belly don't carry the waist. Why they were carrying it like this? Praise the Lord. Why? Because they think too much of their stomach. They don't want to give out. They don't want to spread their hands. Praise the Lord. We should learn to share with people. To learn to share with others. The more you are blessed, the more you should give to those around you and even to those who don't even know you. Praise the Lord. Sometimes I